child take a digestive enzyme? Does it have dipeptidylpeptidase-IV in it? We abbreviate that DPP-IV. Is it really necessary to have DPP-IV in a digestive enzyme? Hi, I'm Dr. Teresa Lyons. I teach parents the cutting-edge science of autism so that you can make the best decision for your child based on quality information. Let's find out what the actual scientific literature says about DPP-IV and autism. Let me get my slides so that you can see what I'm talking about. And if you find this video to be helpful, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel to get the cutting edge scientific information about autism so that you can make the best decision for your child based on quality information.
Is dipeptidylpeptidase-IV in digestive enzymes needed? Let's talk about nutrition. Nutrition strongly influences many chronic inflammatory diseases, with food metabolism being closely linked to inflammatory processes. So obviously we want food to be metabolized as much as possible so that we can extract as much nutrient from the food that we consume as possible and not cause any inflammatory processes. Inflammation could be a result of a rejection of food substance due to our body's immune response. So this is important to keep in mind with food. And the interplay between nutrition, immunity, and inflammation is an extremely hot topic in research, not just in autism, but in many different therapeutic areas. And this is a great thing. Why? Because we can have huge impact and influence on what our children eat. What is a digestive enzyme? Digestive enzymes are able to break down proteins, carbohydrates, and lipids. This is what our body is supposed to do. We are supposed to have optimal level of digestive enzymes. We're supposed to be able to break down our food so that we can have it in nutrients that we can actually use for the different biological processes in our body. Supplementation with digestive enzymes may play a role in the management of digestive disorders from lactose intolerance to cystic fibrosis and many, many different therapeutic areas in between. There's a link below for a general video on digestive enzyme that I've done previously. So if you're interested in more about the general aspect of what is a digestive enzyme and is it really beneficial, is it helpful in that general sense, please click below for a general video on digestive enzymes. Let's get to dipeptidylpeptidase-IV. It is also abbreviated DPP-IV. Dipeptidylpeptidase-IV targets specific peptides. So DPP-IV is a very specific digestive enzyme. DPP-IV breaks apart peptides, which are small proteins that have a particular pattern. These type of peptides have morphine-like action on neuronal cells. Beta-casein morphine 7 is an example of this very specific peptide that DPP-IV can specifically break apart. If you want to get more information about beta-casein morphine 7 and some other research that was done regarding camel milk, there's another link below about a video I've done with camel milk and getting more into the science of what's the benefit of camel milk and why do people actually spend extra money to buy camel milk. Only DPP-IV can actually break down this specific peptide in the gut. What happens? So why are we actually even speaking about DPP-IV? Why isn't there an optimal level in someone's gut? What happens? What happens to actually change that level of DPP-IV? Dysbiosis. That really impacts optimal gut functioning from a variety of ways. So it's very hard to pinpoint exactly where dysbiosis is going to impact a particular person the most. Everyone is impacted differently from dysbiosis. It depends on what the cause is and whether the cause of the dysbiosis is continuing. There's many different factors that go into the impact of optimal gut functioning. And this is why autism can seem confusing, right? Because you can't just apply what worked for one child to another child. Dysbiosis and the gut microbiota It's very complex, and that's what makes autism seem confusing. It doesn't have to be, but that's what makes it seem confusing. DPP-IV can become less prominent and active in the gut with exposure to mercury, pesticides, zinc, cadmium chloride, lead acetate, a variety of different things. Basically, toxic exposure or accumulation of toxins in the body. So maybe your child wasn't exposed, you know, big time to some type of toxic event, but maybe their body is not good at detoxing the everyday things that need to be detoxed. So there's an accumulation. And again, this is why autism can seem confusing, right? Because there can be a variety of reasons as to why something like DPP-IV is less prominent and less active in someone's gut. DPP-IV and autism. Scientists have studied casomorphines and autism and found undigested casomorphines in the urine of autistics. So there's certainly research, published research on this. You can certainly go to the links and read the research yourself if you'd like. This research was done, I think it started like in the 1980s. So this information certainly has been prevalent in the scientific literature for decades. There is no article focusing on DPP-IV and autism. So there's a lot of generality as to undigested casomorphines, but there's nothing specific on DPP-IV, the enzyme, and autism. Conclusions. Many functional medicine doctors recommend a digestive enzymes as one of the first steps to getting healthier, right? That makes sense. You want to get as much nutrients out of whatever you're eating possible, right? Many children are picky eaters, right? So one of the basic steps is, okay, if they're picky eaters, let's make sure at least that we're getting as much nutrients out of their picky eating as possible before even trying to make any changes. If you're going to buy a digestive enzyme, it certainly does seem logical to include DPP-IV in the digestive enzyme itself. And here are some references.